live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
For the end of January, and look at these temperatures. How nice. We warmed up nicely to 67 degrees for a high this afternoon at the JFK International Airport. That is 14 degrees above the average this time of the year, but still far from the record high of 76 degrees set back in 1967. About a record low in the state, 9 degrees just 3 years ago, back in 2014. It was 9 degrees. 42 we started off this morning at the Asheville Regional Airport. That's pretty close to our average high. Warmed up to 50, but it was felt much colder than the 50 degrees in the mountains because of the strong winds at the Asheville Regional Airport. Winds gusted to around 40 to 45 miles per hour this morning. And during the day, it was still quite windy, even gust over 30. So a very chilly day in the mountains, but a very mild day in the upstate. Far from the record highs or the record lows on the state. Outside right now, a live shot in Town Square in Lawrence. Clear skies. Pretty nice evening outside. Current temperature 60 in Lawrence. It's 60 also in Newberry and in Anderson. 66 in Toccoa. Currently mid-40s in Asheville, and it's in the upper 30s right now in Boone. In fact, Boone had a wind gust to about 54 miles per hour overnight last night. So still very windy conditions in the northern and central mountains of North Carolina, as you can see. Winds dying down a little bit in the upstate. And so as the sun continues to go down, the winds will continue to die down outside of the mountains first, and then in the mountains probably well after midnight tonight. More humidity in the northern and central mountains of North Carolina, but only 38% currently in Spartanburg. 61 current temperature in Columbia, 61 in Florence, also in Charleston and in Macon, while it's 45 degrees in the Tri-Cities in Bristol, Tennessee, 45 degrees, 53 in Chattanooga. Look at the warm-up out here and through Oklahoma and Texas. This is the mild weather that's going to spread across our area tomorrow. So one more nice mild day. So enjoy it if you like mild temperatures in the end of January, because winter is going to return and it's going to stay with us for quite a while. As far as precipitation, doesn't look like any precipitation except for a northwesterly flow, snow showers or flurries as we head toward the end of this week into the weekend, but that's about it as far as big storms. Big storm system up the northeast with rain, sleet and snow and a lot of wind, and then some pretty heavy snow in Iowa all the way back into Nebraska and also in through South Dakota with snow showers out here into the Rockies. 24 in Denver right now, still holding steady at the freezing mark in Minneapolis, but look at this, 78 in Dallas, and this is the warmth that's going to spread across our area tomorrow ahead of this cold front. There's the front tomorrow morning. Sunshine to start with, increasing clouds maybe in the afternoon, but nice and warm, unseasonably warm. Here comes the front, so scattered showers, maybe some moderate to heavy showers tomorrow night, but quickly moving out by Thursday morning. And this is when, behind the front, this starts our cooling trim where it continues north-northwest winds for the remainder of the week through the weekend. Clear skies, quite chilly, low 41 degrees, a very cold wind in the mountains, low 36 tomorrow. Mostly sunny skies and mild, high 70. A warmer afternoon in the mountains instead of a northwest wind. It's a west-southwest wind and a high temperature of 66 degrees. 4 day plus looks like this. So we're talking about cooling trend. Yeah, look at this. 70 tomorrow, 60 on Thursday, 50 on Friday, upper 40s on Saturday, and then finally overnight lows below the freezing mark as we head toward the end of this week into the weekend.